it is your buddy Peace and Harmony with you here today. And we're zooming in and focusing in on a very important viewer question, and that is also something that I get in frequently, and that is the feeling kind of being empty while you're around somebody. Feeling an emptiness, feeling like a hollowness, like a shallowness, that there's something missing. Kind of you feel this inner space that is just not feeling very good, and not a feel-good feeling. And then why is this really created, this energy drain? Why is this created in a narcissistic or psychopathic relationship? Well, for one, as we're talking about how a narcissist or a psychopathic treats others, it's very much on the superficial. It's very much on the outside. It's very much for appearance or show only. So when you think about outside versus inside, that's very much how a narcissist or a psychopath, they will relate to people in a very, what's called an objectified manner. In other words, if you're their lover, you know, you might feel happy with, you know, they're being attracted to you, but it can become a very objectified attraction. In other words, not having a sort of closeness of heart, a sort of passion that includes this appreciation for each other. So when we talk about feeling warm and fuzzy and good inside, there is an appreciation of something there. There is a gratitude. That's an internal state. And you can only obtain that state when you enter into a state of being humble or being somewhat, you know, having a humility about you. In other words, not having a pathological sense of self-importance. The narcissist puts all the credit on them, puts the crown on their head, and then makes you basically like a trophy, you know, or, you know, relating to you in that very external fashion versus the internal from the heart empathetic relationship. And so as we mentioned, you know, in the beginning of the relationship, sometimes it seems that is what the ideal relationship is, that external superficial sort of love, you know, where it's based on conditions, conditional love. But if you lose the job, you don't have the money, and next thing you know, you find that they're cheating. You know that you're in a relationship with a narcissist because they're there only for the taking. They're there when the job is good. They're there when the economy was good for you. All of a sudden, they jump ship when they might have to make some adjustments. They might have to curb their spending. You know, they are then out cheating and leaving, you know, everything else in disarray and chaos. So a narcissist will do that. In other words, when called for empathy means the ability to listen, hear, acknowledge, and validate, and then communicate another's feelings. This is an empathy state. This is what we call mirror neurons. This is understanding. It's a presence that you feel. It's a heartfelt presence. When you're around it, you know it. It's kind of like being by a big horse. I mean, they've got a presence. You know, empathy is very much the same way. You feel the strength, you feel somebody's fear, you feel their pain. It's the ability to help them process and then work through to the other side. And so the feeling of emptiness and depression and the resulting apathy or feeling directionless or lost is because that whole encounter has not been exercised or expressed. It is living from like the outside only, or as we call the external locus of control. External locus of control means, you know, going to a restaurant for the sake of the picture. Eating an ice cream not because it tastes good, but, you know, because it looks good on Facebook. You know, it's the looking at the woman with the objectified body, you know, looking at the man with the objectified money, things of that nature. He can, you know, I can depend on them. Whatever the situation that the narcissist is doing, it's all because they want to look good. But that does not always feel good. And so it's the feeling part, the aspect of that relationship, which has not been expressed, has been shut down. And yes, it is possible to feel kind of totally shut down from that state of living. And it's a terrible, horrible thing to do because one becomes exhausted. One basically is going to be crippled with exhaustion from trying to live up to that standard which is set externally and not generated internally. So it's a whole different way of living. And as I mentioned before, it's like having a yardstick against you constantly. Constantly being judged or measured for something, whatever it is. Time, affection, energy, I mean, you name it, there's going to be a measuring stick for it when you're in a relationship with a narcissist or a psychopath. And it's external only, so oftentimes it's very superficial. It's how you feel, how you look on the outside, not how you feel on the inside. And not having that sort of ability to value you for your momentum that you have given in the relationship. For example, you might say, you know, let's do this, let's build this, let's build a cottage, let's get a second property, let's do something, and then they just don't want to follow up on your dreams. Even though it could be very meaningful to you, you know, they will have nothing to do with it. So then they'll squash your dreams because their input might be required. So then it's the assessment where then you have that kind of, you go like through an inner depth, if you will. So that is the cause of the emptiness. That is the why you're feeling like no one has validated me. No one has loved me. No one has heard me. So people then just shut up and go along with it because they don't know better. And there is a naivete, a greenness, if you will, an innocence that gets lost or scrambled in the process. And so that naivete, that sort of wanting to learn again and wanting to grow, that innocence of a child that grabs the stuffed animal and goes, oh, that's so cute, you know, that is the state that you need to get back to. I don't care if you need, you know, some coloring books. I don't care if you need to, get yourself, comforted like a child with a new fleecy blanket. You know, you need to get back to that restorative, innocent state where you can then fulfill yourself and live from, and kind of like coddle yourself, nurture yourself from that space and begin to hold yourself there and say, I've got you now. I have you now. Meaning you have yourself. And once you have yourself, you will not abandon yourself. What ends up happening in the narcissist relationship, people end up basically getting abandoned even though they're in a relationship. They're simultaneously reinforcing an abandonment, and it's just keeping it present always. And that's why it feels so yucky, it feels so empty, and it feels like you don't have or you're less than. It's that constant dichotomy or juxtaposition is a very good word to put. Juxtaposition, which means to put alongside, you know, here you're this bigger one and I'm this, you know, little crumpled one, you know, look at you and I'm, you know, and you feel, you know, nothing. It's always a constant juxtaposition when life is not meant to be constantly separated and severed that way. You are whole, individual, one person, one ball of energy, one glowing light, one flowing cells, you know, of emotion. You have a unique consciousness that is within your body, which means only you have the eyes that have seen what you've seen, that feel what you've felt, have, you know, taken in what you've taken in, all your experiences, the food, the music, and then uniquely combined in you and looking in the present right now with where you're at. Nowhere else in the universe is that spark of energy. It is within you. I mean, that is your consciousness. That is your gift. Conscious means your ability to be alive and be aware and be looking around and taking in. That is consciousness. So that is what's so unique about being a person, and that is the joy and the miracle of life, is that that is where kind of the divine meets within you. And the divine meaning, whatever it is you call it. Something that lifts you up, energizes you, pulls you forth, gives you that challenge to rise up, and then, you know, it's a, you think it's the struggle, but then when you look back to the joy, it really isn't the struggle. It was the divine, a higher power, a stronger power moving you there. So that is where, how you're going to fill that inner well. You're going to fill that inner divot. You're going to fill that inner, roots that have been destroyed. You're going to go in and you're going to find those roots within you, which are of pleasure, happiness, contentment. Not that it's all externally rewarded by this, that, and the other thing, or being evaluated. It's coming back to that unconditional state that will fill you up and energize you. And so I hope that helps you I'll understand that that is the how that 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 depression got set up. So then the coming, you know, and it is a valley, sort of a valley moment where you're down in it, and you need to work through it. And sometimes the physical energy is not there. So I definitely always recommend, make sure that you go and do your annual physicals. Get your checkup, and you know, no matter what country you're in, get your checkup. Begin to value yourself. Begin to take steps each and every day that value that. You know, you're consciously valuing yourself, and do it in a more like an enhanced manner that lets you know, I've got you here. I've got you now. You know, whether it's getting yourself new socks, a new blanket, a new light bulb, a new knife, a new fork, a new spoon, something that now speaks to the inner you that is beginning to fill that up. I need to eat soup. I need to eat rice. I need to eat potatoes. I need to eat a certain cut of meat now. And begin to fill that up and begin to bring it out with that I am. And be then living in that present and then that future, and begin to generate those positive feelings so the depression will subside. And it's not always easy. I do get that. You can't just shake it off. It does take with some getting that momentum together and getting, you know, holding your head up. But you do have to kind of have a vision for your marching steps and begin to move yourself forward through it each and every moment. Even if it takes reminding yourself every minute, every 30 minutes, every hour, get in the habit of that, because once you do that consciously, even if you write it out, keep it going. If you have keep it going written out, that will mean something to you. And if you put that in front of yourself every hour, you'll trigger what that means to you to fulfill that inner well that has been depleted and the reserves have been tapped out. So you need to do something like get some index cards that write, keep it going. You've got this. You've got you now. Freedom is on the way. These are the things that you need to write out and have reinforced for yourself. So because now it's being taken away from you is essentially what has happened. When you are in deep with a relationship with a narcissist or a psychopath, that whole regenerative drive, motivation, as they say, has been taken from you when you're in a relationship with a narcissist, because it's an energy suck. There's, you know, you will feel depressed. You'll feel like your energy has left you. That is a good sign that you are around this sort of psychic vampire, narcissist, or psychopathic individual. Do not be ashamed to make the decision. Do not be ashamed to cut it off. Do not be ashamed to think for yourself. Whoever taught you that you did not have the right thought, the right decision, the right opinion, and shut you out, and now you're in a bad place, you need to realize that this person had maybe overtaken some of your thoughts, and you should not be ashamed to think for yourself. These are the tools and tips that you need to grasp and grasp hold of and begin to really work that moving forward and begin to generate that, and you will get the momentum back. You will get the energy. It will take a little bit of time. You might need to watch this. You might need to do this for 6 months, okay? 1 year, 18 months, 24 months before you really get those legs firm underneath you and it won't wobble. It won't feel empty, and you'll be able to discard, which is empty and non-nutritive, for you and your emotional well-being, your happiness in this life. It is your buddy, Peace and Harmony, with you here today. I hope that these videos do help. Please share and please subscribe for more great tools, videos, discussion, and support.